Good evening and welcome to Poland Daily. I'm Nicholas Richardson and this is the news. The Polish government has introduced measures to limit the spread of coronavirus. These include a ban on mass events, sanitary inspections at all borders, including ferries and long-distance trains. The National Security Council met today to discuss the crisis, the meeting having been called by President Andrzej Duda. There are currently 20 confirmed cases of coronavirus in Poland. Among those infected are General Jarosław Mika, the General Commander of the Armed Forces, who probably became infected during a meeting in Germany of the commanding staff of NATO countries.
According to Minister of Health Łukasz Szumowski, one of the people infected is General Jarosław Mika, General Commander of the Armed Forces, who just returned from a military council in Germany. The persons accompanying the general have been quarantined. The Minister of Health also provided a detailed program of care for persons quarantined. Each day, the Polish police will knock on each quarantined person's door, asking if everything is okay or not, but also asking for confirmation that the person who is in quarantine is in the place where they should be. Earlier, after the morning meeting of the government crisis management team, the Prime Minister Mateusz Morawiecki announced the cancellation of all mass events. We have decided it after our analysis that had shown that one of the reasons of greater spread of the virus in Germany and Italy were mass events. That is why we have strongly recommended that organizers cancel high attendance events. Starting today, sanitary controls will be introduced at all borders, including ferries arriving at Polish ports and intercity long-distance trains. In connection with the spread of the epidemic in Germany, we decided that the border with that country should be secured as our first priority. In the case of Czech Republic, the border crossing is the one where we get the most of the flow from Italy, mainly at the Gorzycki crossing. Still later this morning, right at 11 a.m., a meeting of the National Security Council called by the Polish President Andrzej Duda started. It lasted over 2 hours. Until now, the situation does not look bad, taking into account that we are a nation of 38 million people. Percentage-wise, the number of sick people is very small, but we have to realize that this might change dramatically any day, any moment. That is why I continue to ask everyone to observe all the precautionary measures. In addition to the ban on mass events, there will also be a question about closing schools and kindergartens, although this is the responsibility of local governments. This situation occurs, among others, in Poznań, where schools and kindergartens will be closed from tomorrow as a result of the city authorities' decision. On the other hand, in Warsaw, by a decision of the rector of the Medical University of Warsaw, classes at this university have been suspended. In the morning, the Minister of Higher Education, Jarosław Gowin, said that he obliges universities to urgently proceed to analyzing the possibilities of a transition to online learning.
The Italian authorities have implemented even more extreme precautions than those in Poland. Italy is the main center of the coronavirus in Europe, and today the Italian government restricted unnecessary traveling inside the country.
Despite the fact that the latest data indicates that there are more than 9,000 confirmed cases of the coronavirus, including 463 deaths, the Italian government maintains that there is no need to panic. Italian Prime Minister Giuseppe Conte has introduced a ban on public gatherings to cover the whole country. Schools and universities have been closed until April 3rd. There won't be the red zone anymore, there won't be zone number one, nor zone number two. There is just one Italy now. A good decision to make today is to stay at home. Our future and the future of Italy is in our hands. We have to be more responsible than we ever were before. But all of us are aware that it's not easy to change our habits. The new regulation applies to 60 million Italian citizens who may travel only to work and back, and also to hospital in cases of emergency.
In Holland, it's also corona. You can get it there also. This was booked, and yeah, there was no negative advice for traveling. So we did come, and yeah, and now in Rome, it's all of this. Italy is all closed, but yeah, we don't know anything.
When the train stopped and we got off, they asked us to file some documents. The police officers took a photo of our IDs. I think if we were infected by the virus, they wouldn't have let us go.
The government said that the grocery stores will remain open. Despite the restrictions, Italians are trying to live normal lives.
I've noticed that the people on the trains were very careful. They stood 1 meter apart from each other. I saw people wearing masks, but besides that, everything seemed to be normal.
I didn't notice any risk on the train because there were few people there, maybe 2 people in each car of the train. I'm more worried about the situation in grocery stores because there are more people there. Even the city center has emptied. The media have recently reported about the desperate act of an inhabitant of Rome who paid more than €1,200 to a taxi driver to get her hometown from Milan.
Chinese President Xi Jinping visited Wuhan, the source of the coronavirus epidemic, for the first time since the outbreak. The visit of the Chinese head of state was intended to be a signal to the world that China has now dealt with the threat of COVID-19. However, the World Health Organization remains skeptical and has not excluded the possibility of the virus becoming a global epidemic.
The number of infected around the world keeps rising. There are currently over 110,000 confirmed cases and 4,000 deaths. According to WHO officials, the question of the coronavirus becoming a global epidemic depends on the situation in four countries where there has been the biggest number of infections: China, South Korea, Iran, and Italy.
Now that the virus has a foothold in so many countries, the threat of a pandemic has become very real. But it would be the first pandemic in history that could be controlled. The bottom line is, we're not at the mercy of the virus.
The number of the infected and deaths caused by the virus grow in the United States. 717 cases were confirmed in 32 states. As many as 26 people have died. The Grand Princess cruise ship finally docked in the port in Auckland, where 21 people were confirmed to have been infected. There are 3,500 people on board the ship, five of whom are Poles. The local authorities decided that the passengers are to be sent to two military hospitals in Texas and Georgia, where they will be further quarantined. The crew of the ship will remain under quarantine on board. Some better news come from South Korea, where the Center for Disease Control and Prevention announced that the daily number of new infections is at its lowest for 11 days. As of midnight today, there are 7,212 patients in quarantine due to COVID-19, while 247 people have been released from quarantine after full recovery and 54 people have died. We offer our deepest condolences to the families of the deceased. There were 131 new confirmed cases reported yesterday, bringing the total tally to 7,513.
The president of the Polish Bishops' Conference, Archbishop Stanisław Gandecki, has asked priests to increase the number of Sunday Masses so each is attended by fewer worshippers, in order that the faithful are able to meet the guidelines of the sanitary services on gatherings of large numbers of people. The Archbishop also appealed for prayers to end the epidemic.
In accordance with the instructions of the Chief Sanitary Inspector not to organize large gatherings, I request, as far as it is possible, an increase in the number of Sunday Holy Masses in churches, so the number of faithful present at liturgies could match the regulations proposed by the sanitary services. Hospitals treat the diseases of the body, while churches serve by treating the illnesses of the soul. I therefore can't imagine a situation where we couldn't pray in our churches.
That's the news. Thank you for watching. Stay with us for the weather, Poland Daily Business, and more programs. But from me, it's have a good night and a better tomorrow.